Neuendijk and Lube in with him. Suter and McInnes at the points. Hoke and Lube to Neuendijk. Back to Lube, and they'll go to the point now. Forwards go to the front of the net. McInnes takes the shot, tipped out of the air, and Young made the save. I think Neuendijk got a piece of it. Now Suter shoots one. Young makes the save. Lube picks up the rebound. Suter mishandled the puck. Uh-oh, 66 is on a breakaway.
Well, I guess we won't bench him for not back-checking. Now, he may give up a few with his defensive plays, but boy, he sure smells an opportunity, doesn't he? Suter bobbles the puck. There goes Lemieux. There's no chance that any of the Flames are going to catch him. And when he has got himself into that position, just watch it. Now, you be Mike Vernon right now. You're trying to decide where he's going to put that puck. He's pulled himself, so you draw yourself with him. But his great big long reach gives him such a great advantage of being able to just put that puck where he wants it.
How come he's always around when a mistake is made? He's always the guy.
He does smell it, doesn't he? I mean, great anticipation.
Calgary's power play continues. It's a one-goal game, 3-2 Flames. The Pens are back in it. Here's a pass to Mark Hutter and a shot that hit the skate of Chris Dahlquist in front of Wendell Young. Fans are back into this game now, too. 20 seconds left in the penalty to Bjugstad. Mario Lemieux's 58th of the season, unassisted at 13:44. Mullen on the give and go. The pass doesn't get back from